take some of the herbs and just down around.
You press in a little bit.
Right. Just make sure it sticks. So what we'll do is we'll just get the peel. Okay.
I got a little peel here.
And then what we'll do here is just put a little cornmeal on.
Oh.
And this will keep it just from sticking it when we slide
it
in the oven.
Just plain, ordinary cornmeal.
Right, a little coarse cornmeal. What we want to do is we want to direct the flow of the dough. So what we're going to do is we're going to cut it a little bit so that when it bakes, what would happen is, right, what would happen if we didn't do that, it would grow up into a big heater.
I see.
And it would make a hole in the middle. Yeah. We want to have the bread in there. So we're going to cut it this way, direct it.
And that keeps it from puffing up.
Right. You do that with bread does to direct the flow of the dough the way you want to do.
Mm-hmm.
We'll just put this behind us, and we're going to let it rest for about 10 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
Then the next item we're going to make is we're going to make a traditional fagas.
That's this thing here.
Exactly.
Big, sort of like a big paw.
Right. We're going to do the same thing. Add a little flour to it. Press it down. And we're going to just let out some
That's
of the initial gases
that.
Here.
You can hear it swish out, too.
Yes. And what we're going to do is just try to get it a little pulled out a little bit.
See, that's interesting. On your hand.
Right. Actually, what I'm doing, I'm just pulling it and guiding it. I'm pinching the edges here. Because
mm-hmm.
what I want to try to do is pull the dough out evenly. Basically, what we're doing is just trying to come out to a bit of a teardrop, a little wider on the bottom.
Mm-hmm.
And we're just going to take our little razor blade and just cut it up. Just go push straight down, mm-hmm. divide it a little bit, and
mm-hmm.
you can put as many cuts in there as you want, a little wider, depending on what you so desire.
That's you just push nice. It straight kind down. Of a leaf shape.
Exactly. And what we're going to do here is...
And this just opens it up, does it?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
You want to keep those gaps in there. And then what we're going to do is we're going to take this and we're going to put it on a sheet pan.
And that's with that plastic paper on.
Right, a little parchment paper.
Parchment.
And the reason why we do bake it on a sheet pan is that it'd be very hard to slide this off a peel and keep it shape.
It would.
So just pick it up gently
mm-hmm.
and lay it down.
Isn't that beautiful?
Oh. Okay. And then one of the traditional parts about it is the oil and the herbs.
And you're pressing them in as you put it.
Right. What I do is I just grab a bunch in my hand and mm-hmm. I just put it on there and it actually sticks to it.
Yeah.
And then what we'll do there, we'll add some of the coarse sea salt. And that's the.
Is that the same as kosher salt?
No, I think this is just actually salt that's in the rough. It'll hold and won't dissolve once it's baked.
Oh.
You want to see that like a nice large size pretzel. So we'll do now the same thing. This we'll just put it on the side and let it
mm-hmm.
rise up
a little
bit.
That's fascinating.
Right. Yeah. What we're going to do here is we're going to take our last dough. The dough is very good for a dessert or a sweet item too.
Oh.
So what we do here is we just take pat it out the same exact way. A little bit more flour. Take out some of the gases. Be gentle with it. You don't need too much pushing. What we're going to do here is I'm going to cut it to four pieces. Okay. Just put it right on here. Now what we're going to do with these are, we're going to make fresh fruit focaccias, and then we're just going to make just a little baked sweet item. How we do that is, we're just going to brush them again with oil, because we're just dampening it. The flavor is not going to really have an effect on it. Some people rather not have the herb in there, but
I think
the sugar we're going to put on there.
Using herbs with sweet things. No,
sure,
anyway.
It's one of the new things people are doing.
Have to keep up today.
Today's times.
Yes, sir.
What we're going to do is just take some turbinado sugar, which is basically sugar in the raw. Hasn't been processed.
It's not brown sugar.
Right.
I guess you get that at this
health food store. Exactly.
Yeah.
We're just going to take some fresh berries.
Hmm.
Which look really, really nice. Look great. And with this, what we're going to do a little bit is cut the inside.
Mm-hmm.
And that's so it doesn't blow the fruit exactly off. The dough is so strong. So we're going to just push that down a little bit, cut it up.
Oh, it looks awful, doesn't it?
It's just very simple from there. Just any kind of berries. We'll make one on blueberries, we'll make on raspberry. Now you can use any fruit you desire.
Strawberries,
peaches are very nice. Whatever's in season. In the wintertime, apples. Granny Smith apples are really, really nice.
That would be nice.
Yes. And then what we like to do here is just add a little sprinkle topping on it.
Oh, what's that?
This is a little brown sugar mixture with some butter, some cinnamon, some regular sugar. Mm-hmm. I'm just going to put it on top there. And this is also going to be very nice. And the real nice thing about making this, we're not going to fry it. So just bake, and it's going to be low cholesterol, and people are worried about fats today. So we have a little sweet without having to fry it.
You're not going to put whipped cream on it.
Well, maybe afterwards we can with something
people
else there.
People can do what they want.
Exactly. Once it comes out, you can ice cream or cream or whatever
else. It really looks like we're starting to rise right now.
It is. It is. I think maybe we can put it in the oven. And we can start with our other ones because they've made rest a little bit.
Okay.
And we'll let these rest for a while.
Fine.
While we put those in. The plain focaccia right here is actually going to be from the stone.
There, you got a hot stone there.
What we want to do is just easily slide that off.
And that, yes, and that cornmeal.
Right, and then what we'll do, we'll put the other one underneath. So what we want to do is put it in a 450 degree oven for about 20 minutes or so. Yeah. And then we'll be seeing what happens after we come out.
Oh, that looks, that's good. Now, how do you know it's done? That's one of
the questions. By the color and the time that's in there, but also you want to do is be able to just flip it over and it's nice brown and be nice solid there.
If it ain't brown on the bottom, it ain't done.
Right. It needs a little bit more firmness. What we'll do now, I guess, we'll just put in the dessert and the sweet focaccias that we did.
Mm-hmm.
Put those in for our 20 minutes or thereof.
Good.
Okay. Here's our square focaccia, that we had made prior to that. And today we have a nice grilled vegetables that we had done. Nice marinade, whatever you like, and as far as dressings, nice balsamic vinegar and oil. What we're going to do here is just going to cut it in half. Okay. Very nice holes and pockety.
Smells good.
Right, and that's what we've been trying to do as far as create all this. What we can do here is put a little olive oil that we were using the time for. You can use a pesto or anything you'd like. And then take some zucchini.
These are all sort of grilled or boiled vegetables.
Right, exactly.
Yep.
Zucchini, then we go to a different color here. Maybe we'll try some red tomatoes in here. So then we can just maybe grab some eggplant here.
And these are those ones?
Roasted peppers. Very nice.
Love them.
Maybe a little basil here.
A basil smells so good.
It's nice and green. How about some yellow? Yellow tomatoes on there.
Those are lovely, aren't they?
Very nice. And we can put some goat cheese on there. That's always nice. Break that up and just crumble it on top. From here, it's either finished or what we can do is just put it right in the oven and it's great to melt it all and bring it all to a nice warm temperature.
Just leave it on an just open face?
You can use it for open face like that or actually put the top on there. Maybe put it in there and let it melt a little bit. You want to put this in there to crisp back up. But one of the ways we can do it is we're just going to warm it up a little bit. Put the top back on. And we have a baking sheet over here. Put it in there.
Is that a no-stick?
That's a no-stick. That's fine. We have a nice crust on the bottom. And we can go from there. Put it right in here to warm.
These are coming up
nice. These are coming up very nice. We just have to wait for all this to go.
Well, look what we've done. It's not very long with these fruit tarts and these. I don't know what you're going to do with. And this wonderful sandwich. That fougasse. I think this is very impressive, Craig. How do we eat it now?
Well, we just cut in. Let's just start with the sandwich first.
Okay.
What we'll do is just push that down.
not to heat it up in a 400 degree oven.
Right, just for a couple minutes.
Sun will do it, you know.
Just to... Nice.
When you
nice
serve it, you have it cut up and then people...
No, I think you could bike if you're a son. Yeah. I believe one of the nicest things about this is just putting it on, and it's very festive, just putting it on the table.
And then letting people eat it themselves.
Eat it themselves, exactly.
That's where that warming up made the cheese melt. That looks
right.
Lovely.
And it also crisps up the bread.
Yeah. Then you just take a big bite.
That's it. I think you just grab it with your hands there.
Mmm.
Nice.
Mmm.
Very nice. Crispy.
All the vegetables carefully made.
Exactly.
Mmm. That's delicious.
Now we can take the sweet ones. This is the focaccia that we had just brushed with a little oil and put on the turbinado sugar. It caramelizes really, really nice. And just
sweet.
Exactly. There's a lot of things you can do with this. You just put it here. You take a plate like that. You can put fresh berries. These make great ice cream sandwiches.
Well, then you'd put ice cream on top.
Sure. But what we're going to do here today is we're going to put some nice mascarpone cheese on there. This makes a nice, simple dessert. Put this on here. And then maybe just take a little powdered sugar. Just finish it like that.
That looks very nice. Then you pick it up and eat it.
Right. Or you can use it with a knife and fork.
Yeah.
And the other ones we made here are just the regular simple ones where we've just put the fruit right in there.
Mm-hmm.
And you can do the same thing with here by warming them up and putting ice cream on them.
Just like, a nice little bit of ice cream would go good.
Sure. And this also
powdered sugar.
This is a breakfast item in the morning, too.
Yeah, that would be.
Other than a fried donut or a Danish. And that's what we have here.
And then what about your
fugas? This is the fugas here. It just came out of the oven. It's still a little warm.
Mm-hmm.
What we're going to do is we're going to brush it with a little oil. And what that's going to do is just take off the excess flour.
Mm-hmm.
And give it a nice little shine.
Mm-hmm.
And then it's going to be ready for service.
It's really not a soggy, it's just a little...
No,
little,
exactly. You don't want to dampen the nice crust that you just
cosmetic.
Built.
Cosmetic.
Right, that's all it is.
Yeah. It looks lovely.
That's it.
And then how do you eat it?
Find the best way to do it is just ripping apart.
Oh, let's see you do that.
Okay, let's break this in half. And rip it.
Well, I think people love doing that, don't they? Well... Look
that's
at
right.
that. That's beautiful.
Nice texture and all the arables that we've worked so hard to in the time to do it.
Look at all this. This really is a wonderful illustration, and this is not only about half of what you can do, isn't it?
Exactly.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. I enjoyed myself tremendously being here with you.
Be with you. Thank you.
Complete recipes for all the breads, cakes, cookies, and pies in this series and more are available in the Baking with Julia cookbook. Over 500 pages, detailed instruction, and 100 color photos. To order, call 1-800-